Hi, caller. You're on with Dr. Nina.
Oh, hello, Dr. Nina. Thank you for taking my call. How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you. I was looking for some advice on how I could potentially do a little bit of a better job at my job.
Have you called me before?
No. My name's Murky. I'm the cold open guy with the not even a show. I just need people to say, "Let's start the show."
Let's start the show.
Oh, you're the best, Dr. Nina. Thank you so much. You've made this little boy happy.
Excellent. Have a great day. Hi, Dr. Nina, you're on. Hi.
Hey everyone, I'm Chris. I'm a person just like you, and this is the Not Even a Show. I guess one way that I'm not exactly like you is that I have a time machine, and I've used my time machine in the past to go into the future and check on this year's election results, and I don't want to spoil them for you, but they are good and they will make you happy, and I know that for a fact. But it made me think, what direction is that going to send the country? And so I took my trusty time machine and I went into the future, into the year 2032, and I decided to see who was the president at that point, and it turns out it's the kid from Two and a Half Men. He's like a fucking communist or something. Anyways, we've got a great episode for you this week, as we've got some new blood. That's right, two new red hosts named Steve Gruber and Steve Cortes. Also, the tailgater meets a new friend named Matt Wyatt. Plus, we check in with an old friend named JJ McCartney. First, though, Sebastian Gorka has a huge fucking head, and we love calling him about that, and we've been calling him for a long time, and it's getting harder and harder to get on, so sometimes you have to be very patient and wait for the entire show, and then you're the last caller in the last minute, and that's what happened this week. Check it out.
Thank you, John. Let's go to Felix, who's been waiting for
at least an hour and a half.
Felix, line two from Flint, Michigan.
Welcome to America First.
Hello, Dr. Gorka. I am so glad for you to finally take my call.
All right, you've got a minute. You've got to be quick, Felix. Tell me why you called.
Go fast.
No problem. So the Project Veritas video, I wanted to get your thoughts on that with Bernie saying that we should kill landlords and the such, and people thought he was drunk, but I wondered if you could find yourself in that position and see yourself in a video like that. Of course you couldn't, because your head is far too large. Fuck you.
It's amazing the dedication these people have.
Am I gonna tell me when I come back on? This is crazy. That liberal waited for 2 hours. I'm so glad. We'll get to you as well. I'm Sebastian Gorka. Watch your six. This is America First. Stay frosty, my friends.
Stay frosty,
my friends.
Steve Cortes loves Donald Trump so much that he actually runs a super PAC for him, and even had his heritage used for political gain by the president himself. More importantly, though, he got a call from us this week, and you're about to watch it. Check it out.
All right, we're talking about John Bolton and witnesses, because the two are intrinsically linked. We're going to go to Pat in Lockport. Pat, what are your thoughts?
I love Trump with all my heart and soul, and I hope to God he makes it in this next election. But these witnesses are insane. And furthermore, how many of these Democratic losers, like Atkinson and Schumer.
Right. Pat, listen, we got a lot of callers. I don't mean to, I wish I could listen to more, but we're going now to Jason. Jason, what are your thoughts on on Bolton, witnesses, etc.
Hey, Steve, thanks for taking my call. You know you're doing something right when you got intelligent people like Pat calling into your show. Hey, it's a real good indicator that you are doing something well, right?
Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
Anyways, my question, you're a big supporter of Trump, obviously. I don't know that you've ever come out and spoken out against Trump, and I think that's something that's admirable, you know, that you have that, you know, you're going to stick by him no matter what. I'm just curious if you
Jason, let me stop you for a second. I do want to hear your question, but not no matter what. No, listen, Trump has done things. I actually just mentioned the previous segment. As much as I admire this man, he doesn't walk on water, and he makes mistakes. Not many, but go ahead, please, Jason. What's your question?
Well, my question, I guess, is at the end, when it's all said and done, do you think that maybe he'll give you a little pat on the head and say you're a good boy or no?
Why would I want a pat on the head?
Well, I mean, it seems like that's why you do everything. It seems like everything is motivated by wanting the president to give you a pat on the head and tell you you're a good little boy.
Okay.
Well, first of all, I'm not little and I'm not a boy.
So, Jason, if that were the case, I'm talking now. I let you talk. Why would I say what I just said, which is that the president was wrong? Why would I say that if I'm, as you say, a little boy who's angling for attention from the president?
Well, that's a good question. You might actually...
it's a good question. That's why I asked it. Answer it, Jason.
Yeah. So you might not want to say that if you want him to pat you on the head.
Well, I just did. Answer the question, Jason.
Clearly what motivates your life. You
going to answer the question, Jason?
All the decisions. Sorry?
You going to answer the question? Why would I say that if I'm so dying for his approval?
My question is how...
No, I'm asking the question now, Jason. All right, we're done with Jason. Makes no sense. If I was dying for this president's approval...
I wouldn't say things like that.
I'm critical of him when warranted. But I'm not critical very often because it's not warranted. Thank goodness.
The Tailgater loves calling Patrick Netherton and talking sports. But there's other shows that talk sports as well. So the Tailgater went out looking for a new pal to talk with, and he found one in Matt Wyatt. Check it out.
Jason is in Idaho. Is this the same Jason that's in Arizona and he just happens to be in Idaho?
No, different one.
It's a different Jason. We got a Jason in Arizona. Now we have a Jason in
Idaho listening. What's up, Jason?
Hey, double Jason on the horn. You can call me Gator if you want. I'm known as the Tailgater amongst my friends, so I go by Gator sometimes.
Atta
that
boy.
Might help differentiate.
I like it. I like it. Gator the Gator Tailgater. Jason.
You like it? you do a little tailgating every now and then, Matty. You ever get out there on the tailgate, throw a couple back before the festivities?
No. Jason.
Do you drink alcohol? I'm just trying to figure out how close of a friend you're going to become to me in this world. Are you an alcohol drinker?
No, I'm not a big alcohol drinker. Although I do think the state of Idaho might drive a lot of people to drink. Don't you have a lot of snow?
Well, to be honest, I don't oftentimes leave my house, so I couldn't tell you that. And when I hear you got a lot of snow, I start thinking about, you know, drugs and everything. And no, I do not do that, sir. I am strictly on the booze. He's a motherfucking tailgater. Strictly on the drinking.
Look,
I'm excited
you're the one that asked me if I drink alcohol. I innocently brought up snow, and you immediately turned it into
cocaine.
Well, you don't understand the people I run with, man. I hear snow, and it only means the only other thing it could mean is famed Canadian rapper Snow, who famously sang the song Informer. Right, we all know that.
Right.
What are your plans for Sunday for the Super Bowl? Are you gonna Ned Flanders it up, sit there with your water while all the boys are having a good time, or what?
In my Yeti cup right here, Jason, in Idaho.
You know what's in this Yeti cup as we speak?
Fresh,
clean. Not going to impress me.
Filtered water. Yeah, I'll be drinking some water, maybe a Diet Dr. Pepper, having some
guacamole,
some chicken wings.
I like a guacamole. I make a special guacamole that's got rum in it. He's a motherfucking tailgater. Oh
get a little drunk while you're eating some chips and dip, baby. I'm just messing around. I love your show. You're a lot of fun. I love calling these sports shows. I'm kind of well known as a sports show caller. And I like your vibe, man. You're cool, even though you don't drink. And I feel like you do drink, but you don't want to tell me. And I think you might be one of those guys who you get a little nasty when you drink. So maybe you're not allowed to. And I respect that, Maddie. I'll talk to you soon, baby.
Talk to you soon. I don't know if you just got punked or not. But it's okay. It was all fun.
I think it was fantastic. What did he say? He likes to put rum in his guacamole.
Right.
In the next segment, let's get on a representative here on the show from Alcoholics Anonymous. I just wish I could figure out who that is.
I wish I could figure it out.
Well, he said he's originally from Mississippi and a transplant up there, but he sure sounds like a native Idahoan.
He sounds northern.
Yeah, that's been there a long time.
Hey, Roger, he ain't from around here.
Steve Gruber hosts a show on the same network as Steve Bannon, the America's Voice News Network, or AVN for short. And that's not a problem. I don't know any other things that use that acronym. But the point is, this guy has the worst fucking audio you'll ever hear in your entire life. And I don't understand how a fairly large network like this is putting out this type of bullshit. Anyways, he gets a call from the Fat Master. Check it out.
AAA 900 9966. Jason checking in from Lansing today with some insight. Jason,
what's on your mind?
Hey, Steve, thank you for taking my call. I appreciate it. Loving watching the live stream on Facebook here. Just enjoying the program. Got up early for it.
Thank
I
you.
Love the background. That background is impressive behind you in the studio. Or is that a green screen?
You know, those are secrets we can't share here.
That's very funny. I'm known as the Fat Master, I guess, is the main thing. I'm known as the Fat Master, and I'm calling. I'm batching off to these shows and everything, and that's
right.
First and foremost.
So what do you think the biggest threat is? You called with a topic. What's on your mind?
I do. That's essentially what always happens. I got that topic, I call in, but what's on my mind is something entirely different. You know what I'm saying? I started thinking about the song or something, you know, like, I just called. I'm batching.
All right. Good enough. Jason, good to have you. Greatly appreciate it. Enjoy your morning, young man. I'm rooting for you. There you go. Jason, a little bit happier than the average listener and viewer. And good for him.
I just called to say I'm batching. I just called to say I'm jacking my butt.
We often go back and forth on the shirt bit, feeling like it's good, feeling like it's bad, doing it, not doing it, deciding we're going to call JJ, deciding we're not going to call JJ. And this week, the shirt bit was off. I decided, you know what, it's too much. I'm not calling. But then I watched his show and I saw what he was wearing and I honestly could not help myself. Check it out.
Rocking better shirts than you.
All right, who's next? Let's see. Let's go to area code 515. You're on the JJ McCartney show.
Okay, that actually is a nice.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Thank you.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Thank you.
Loving the JJ crew. Loving the JJ crew.
Johnny, is that you?
Yes, sir, it is me.
Hey, Johnny.
Not sure I can talk about no shirt. Fuck that idiot.
We only have about 30 seconds before we have to break for the top of hour, Johnny. If you want to hang on the line, we'll get into the conversation next hour with you and IQ Al Rasuli.
Oh.
And we go to area code 818. Hello, you're on the JJ McCartney show.
Hi, JJ. My name is Shirley, and I just wanted to say Shirley.
You got anything else to say? Huh? Really? Wow. That was deep. That was really deep. Sorry we lost the caller for some reason. IQ.
I decided to stop calling JJ. He might get a prank, but not from me. See, we're not out to get him, but that's the way it seems. And so I decided to not call his stream. But then I saw this shirt, and I was a caller. I saw the tie-dye, I knew I had to holler. I'm in love with the shirt fit. I couldn't stop it if I tried.
One of the main laws that that kid from Two and a Half Men made in 2032 is that you have to jack off 4 times a day. It's not easy for everyone. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, everyone. I really appreciate it. And if you're just not quite gotten enough, if you're just thinking, man, I want a little bit more of that absolute bullshit, head over to patreon.com/noteven a show. We've got a fantastic bonus episode for you this week, as we've got Nigel Farage. Yeah, pretty big name for the bonus episode. Also, Tom Gully and the Bubba Army. All right, folks, thank you so much for watching and everything that you do. And vote Bernie. He wins, but... make sure that he does. Okay, bye.